It is Wednesday. Oops. December 7th, 2016. 2 days late, obviously. That last 2 days were a little busy. I could not get around to it. Let's see here. Last week, if you noticed by the video, it is Titanfall 2, if you know your Titanfalls. There was a free weekend last week, and I got to go play that and enjoy that, I guess. I played it to level 10, which, you know, I felt like was enough time. this video, I believe, contains the last two videos, last two or three couple of games before I hit level 10, and I stopped playing. I only really played like attrition and not really much else. Let's see here. So yeah, it's okay. Titanfall 2 is okay. It's not great. It's not as good as the original Titanfall. I mean, a lot of people are liking it, and I guess that's good. But it's not as good as the first two games. It's just not good as the first two games. The first two games. It's just not as good as the first game. And, stupid phone. It's just not as good as the first game. And, it's missing some core things. Being able to rodeo a Titan and beat him with your gun. Shoot into the wiring and stuff on the inside. That was great. That was my favorite thing to do. The Spitfire with the slammer attachment onto it. And it's gone. What do? You take out the dumb battery. You take out the battery and you try and get away. That's all you can do. And that sucks. But it's like you take out the battery and they kill you. And then they get out of their Titan and put the battery back in, and all of a sudden their Titan has a shield, which they did not have originally. So that's some bullshit right there. That doesn't make any sense at all. It's stupid. So this video is with the Titanfall 2 game. On Tuesday, I think I mentioned in my last video, because I think I did on Tuesday also, maybe one day. I don't know. I didn't check. I'm not going to check into it. But last week I got a new physical therapist because of my old one. His last day was Friday, and I'm not around. Or he's not around. He went up to Washington. Went back to Washington. Moved out to Washington. So this week was meeting my new physical therapist, and it was like basically the first day again where she figures out what's up with my shoulder and, you know, what movements hurt it and stuff like that. So she's doing these little tests and everything. And what she was doing is she's really, like, pushing into my shoulder. And, of course, just touching my shoulder right now is sore. But, like, just digging in. And she's got some real bony fingers. And it was not comfortable at all. But, you know, powered through it. And I went off to my regular workout that little Chris has me do. And it was kind of difficult, but it wasn't, you know, I was also kind of sick. I didn't go to the gym like usual, and I just woke up and I felt terrible. So I didn't go to the gym, and then if I didn't go to physical therapy, I had to pay for $25, you know, fee. So I went to physical therapy. But at the end, like, I was basically there for an hour, you know. I was pretty much there the whole hour. And the last thing that she had me do, that Chris had me do, really was, you know, that wavy bar that I mentioned before. I had to do it with my left arm. I had to do it with my left arm and my right arm, but, you know, my left arm. And, you know, raise it up and raise it down. And I couldn't do it. I couldn't pick up my arm more than 20 degrees while trying to do it. It just would not work. And they thought, oh, good, you know, this is, we found a pain of his, and he won't be able to do this, and they can work off of that. But that was not the case. It was because she was digging her fingers into the muscle that the muscle would not want to work, so I had to stretch it out and everything. And I that's it. That was the end of my class, my end of my session. So I get to go back next week and see how it goes. Work, you know, that was, you know, work hasn't been that great either. It was actually slow. I've never seen it so slow on a Saturday before at there at that pizza place. It was so slow. There was like six drivers and then two cooks, including the managers, and that was it. And that's all we needed. It did not get busy or hectic at all. That was enough to do the job on a Saturday. Are you kidding me? I go, Domino's never had a Saturday that bad. It was ridiculous. That being said, I still haven't heard back from Amazon yet. I don't think I will. Not because of any thing about me, but just because they have enough people in this area. And I think that's the thing. I think they see, because you have to turn on the GPS to use the app, and they see, okay, he lives here. Well, we don't need anybody here, so we're not going to go further with the step. So I bet if I went to a different location, you know, I might get a possible chance. And I have no problem at all driving anywhere else in this city to deliver out to. I don't expect to just deliver in this area. I'll deliver anywhere out in this area, in this huge city, the Phoenix metroplex of cities, you know, Scottsdale, Chandler, Gilbert, Glendale, Peoria, Sun City, Avondale, Litchfield, Goodyear, Buckeye, you know, any of those cities out here. Tolleson. It'd be great. So I think I'll send them an email and say, hey, I'll be happy to deliver in this, because it's all basically Phoenix, you know. So I'll give that a shot. Yesterday, I went to, I had lunch with a friend, and while out there, I decided to go to the Fashion Square Mall. It's a very nice mall. If there was ever a zombie apocalypse in it, it would be, it looks like Willamette. It looks like Willamette in the first Dead Rising. I haven't played the fourth one yet, and I'm not very excited to do so, because they kind of do the same bullshit that Respawn did with like Titan and remove stuff, and Halo Wars with the characters. Anyways. I went there, and I went to the Microsoft store. I went to the Microsoft store because of my controller, you know? My Elite controller, this key is loose, as I try and show you right now. There you go. This key's a little loose there. And that's not good. In Halo, I use it to jump and clamber. In Gears of War, I use it as my tech comm. But I use it a lot. And I don't know what the hell. It's a $150 controller, you know. So I took it to the Microsoft store and I asked him, hey, what can you do about this? And he said, well, usually if it's, you know, even if it's an Xbox or the controller, you know, they could just swap it out, because they can do that. But because it's an Elite controller, they can't, because they just don't have any spares like that laying around. So I'll give support a call and see what happens. After the mic, oh, you know, and I was there and I asked good old John, who's the guy I was talking to, if they were hiring. And he said, I believe so. So he goes and talks to the manager. The manager gives him a card, you know, good old Microsoft card. And that's all, the colors are all weird, huh? Because gives him a good old Microsoft card, and the card, you know, says to fill it out and fill out an application, stuff like that. And it turns out that they aren't hiring at that particular store. They're hiring out in Chandler, which is even further away from me than Fashion Square. And that's just really far. So I don't know. I'm sure they don't even pay that much. Afterwards, I went to, within the store, I saw the Microsoft Surface Studio Pro Surface Studio computer, which is, you know, just a huge tablet PC, and, you know, touchscreen tablet PC, and it has a pen, and it has, you know, and it has a mouse, and it has like a dial thing, and it's really cool. So I got to see that, and, you know, for $3,000, it looks really nice. And I keep hitting the camera. It looks really nice, you know, right up there with my next purchase, bubblegum. After that, I went over to the Tesla store, because it's right across the way. Microsoft store's right here, Tesla store's right there, you know. And so I went inside, and I started talking to... I don't even have any picture, that's funny. I didn't take any pictures, but I was talking to good old Jeremy over there, and just asking him random questions, and what they have in the future, and this and that, and I talked to him for about 30 minutes, just, you know, talking about the car, the Tesla cars, the new one coming out, the 3, the Model X, which is a little mini SUV, miles and stuff. It was awesome. So I asked Jeremy for a card and see about a job, and I looked online, and they are hiring in like every position imaginable for a company. I mean, it just kept going on for days. Most of the stuff's in Fremont, Silicon Valley, you know, but they had a couple of stuff here locally. They have apparently a supercharged station over in Buckeye, which would have been nice to work at, I guess, just because it would be kind of closer or easier to get to. Because I can just take the 10 east, west, and I'd be there. But here, I got to go through the city to get over to Fashion Square. But it would be nice to get a job at this point in any situation. So, no. I'll give that a shot. Tesla, you know, it seems like a really cool company, obviously, to work at. Good old crazy Elon Musk over there wants to do all this cool stuff. All these good things. So... it's worth a shot to work for somebody who seems like a genuine good person and not a piece of shit like my previous managers. You know who you are, previous managers. God, I can't even remember my last manager's name. Gil? No, I don't think so. Oh, man. Oh, dude, I think I'm done with talking. I think that's it. I really didn't have much to say this week. Not only did I not have much to say this week, but I don't really have much to say next week. I will talk about Dead Rising 4. It came out yesterday, and people were very unhappy with it, myself included. Like I said, I don't have it yet, but that's only because I don't feel like buying it. It's so removed from what made the original Dead Rising. Everybody's like, oh, well, they took the timer away. That's great. I was like, well, that means you just suck. I mean, games used to be difficult, remember? And the time limit on things was awesome because it gave a sense of urgency. And, you know, you had to figure things out, in this time frame. And which is completely possible. Completely possible. Especially when you rank up and you get stronger and everything, you can take care of everything real fast. It was awesome. But they took away that. They got rid of the voice actor that was Frank West, and by doing so, they also changed his character model, so it doesn't even look like him. He used to look like Fat Dan Aykroyd. Now, he just... I don't know, he looks weird. Of course, the voice actor and the character model, they look exactly the same now because they made the model look like the voice actor. Which is okay if it wasn't Frank West. If they just called him anything else, you know, any other name, if he was a new character, that would have been fine. I mean, Chuck Green was a good guy. Nick Santos was a good guy, right? That was his last name, Santos. Anyways, this new guy just... like, I'd like to like him, but he's not Frank West. He's not the Frank West I've known all these years. Since Xbox 360 first launched. That's not my Frank West. Like I said, it's the same thing in Halo Wars 2. they changed the voice actors for the guy and the girl for Cutter and Anders. And by doing so, they made the character models look more like the voice actors for a connection or some shit, I guess. And they no longer look like the characters in the previous game. And when you buy Halo Wars 2, like special edition or whatever, you get the original Halo Wars remaster for the 360 and the Xbox One. So you get to go through the story mode, to catch up and figure out what's going on. And then you get to play and see Anders and Cutter, and they don't look anything like each other. And that is so stupid. It is so damn stupid. I mean, they could change the voice actor, you know, but to change the character model altogether, that is just dumb. This is false. This is a fictional world, and they could change the voice actors plenty of times. Like they do in Pokemon. They change the Pokemon characters is completely, like every freaking season. All the voices, I don't even know who the hell voices any of the cartoons. And I just know the original seasons, nobody's carried on, right? And like Sonic the Hedgehog, all right? Well, they've changed that character model around, but he's still pretty generally the same, okay? I think only Mario's the one that's stuck the same character and voice, but changing, I'm not talking about the right things anymore. They did not need to change the character models because that's what Cutter and Anders looked like in the original game. And even if it was a slight change, kind of like how they do with Cortana every Halo, she looks different from game to game, but she's still basically Cortana. But, Cutter's had some very defined, like, cheeks, and now he has, like, this weird, like when you put your thumb into clay and you smoosh it down like that, that's what his face looks like. And they gave him a beard. The voice actor doesn't even have the beard. And Cutter didn't even have a beard. He had a mustache. And then Anders was Asian, but I think she's white now. So, it's stupid. Marvel vs. Capcom 4 or Infinity is coming out. And apparently there's not going to be any X-Men, any mutants in it. Obviously because Marvel's still being pissy. Well, they're not being pissy, but they don't have the complete rights to those franchises because Fox still owns them, and because of that they want to prevent Fox from getting any royalties or whatever in the sense. So it sounds like they're not going to be any in this game. And then what sucks even more, what's cool is they're going to release Marvel vs. Capcom 3 Ultimate on the PS4 and the Xbox One. And the PC, the Xbox One and the PC is until March, but they're going to release them, but they're re-releasing them. They're remastering them, so they're 1080p, 60 frames per second. But they're not going to do backwards compatibility, just like the Dead Rising games. The Dead Rising games are not backwards compatible, so if you wanted to play them on the 360, or on the Xbox One, you have to repurchase the games again. And in situations like that are the few times where I feel like, you know what, I'd rather buy the game used. I'm always about buying a new game because that money will go towards the developer or the publisher or whatever, somebody who's responsible for the production of the game. But when Capcom does this shit where they do not, I know they're hurting financially, but they could just say, hey, Microsoft, can we have this game on backwards compatibility? They're like, yeah. And then they can also resell more copies of the game, the physical copy. Sure, that's money too, but also digital copies of the game. Because since they're working again with Marvel, the license has been renewed, so they can now sell the game again. So they could have made money on the backwards compatibility version of the game and not release a remaster version when it's only 1080p, 60 frames per second. It's not like they're going up to, like they're adding any new characters or they're, making the graphics look better or anything like that. And Marvel vs. Capcom 3 didn't ever look really that good. I didn't like the art style. I miss the sprites. Marvel vs. Capcom. Marvel vs. Capcom 2. Gorgeous. They look great. Now, eh. So, Ultimate or Infinity is also taking place with the 3D models. And they're using Infinity Stones. And eh. I'm sure. I don't know. I don't know what the hell's going on in that game. Will I get it? I don't know. Like I said, I'll probably get it used. What else? What else? What else? What else? Ah, Gears of War had a title update on yesterday or the day before. I had, I don't know already. But it contained a new map called Spayer and then Glory. And if you have the season pass and the developers, playlist is available to you. You get to play the maps for a week prior to being released to the rest of the public and put into rotation. And by doing so, you also get a 20% bonus in credits and XP, which is really nice if you use bounties also, because it also stacks with the bounties. So that's what I've been doing. With all that scrap I got over the Carmine 10th anniversary extravaganza, crafted a lot of King of the Hill bounties, because that's what everybody really is playing, is King of the Hill. And, you know, I'm getting like 16,000 experience points a game, you know, leveling up 4 or 5 levels a game. And then, you know, you get a lot of these, credits too with it. So it's pretty nice. I'm just saving up my credits now, waiting for the next event. Not really buying any packs. The next event is going to be the Gearsmiths and Union Independent Revolution, I guess they're called. I don't know, it's from the books, the Pendulum War books. And apparently those packs came out accidentally. And I'm sure you can find it online, because I had no idea about this, but you can find them on YouTube. A bunch of these other YouTube jokers here opening a bunch of packs and getting all those items. The Gearsmith stuff is just like some light skins with different Christmassy stuff on it. Gingerbread guns and mistletoe on the armor and stuff like that, you know, wrapping paper and whatever. Nothing too great. Like, if like it was like an actual character model, that would have been awesome. Like, one of the Lokes, one of the Swarm already looks kind of like a snowman, because he's really white and he's got like a round, smushed up head. But they didn't go that far. They didn't make new models. But they did make new models for the UIR. There's, like, I don't know, 3 or 4 different character models. And they're like full body armor, full helmet, so there's nothing visible about them at all. And, jeez, I hate this. I need to remake this stupid thing. And, they look okay. I'll stick with my Carmine for a while. That was a Gears of War update. Halo. Now, Halo is a different story. It's funny that the Gears of War update came out, and then 343's got, you know, has been announcing stuff for their update yesterday and today, and it's coming out tomorrow. And they have all these announcements, and it's awesome. You know, you got two different new canvases, you got at least 650 different items for Forge. Boundaries and stuff that, like, where when you walk into them, a specific thing happens, like it triggers something. So they show that when you walk into this boundary, it's like you're being underwater. So that was really awesome. New game modes, showing how to make game modes, showing how they made like a King of the Hill variant. They have race modes. They showed new armor, new vehicles, new weapons, new assassinations, new stances. They showed all this great stuff, and it comes out tomorrow for free. And I mean, like the two maps for Gears of War. They also showed the Wreck voice packs, which are really nice. It has Spartan Buck, And, what was his name? Yabda. Merciless. Yabda the Merciless. That's what it was. He's a grunt. And then 031 Exuberant, I think it was. I don't know. 36, something like that. It's like a Guilty Spark, you know? It was like he's a monitor. And they'll be the new voices you can select and have them do lines and stuff for Warzone Arena. That'd be pretty cool. So when that comes out tomorrow, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I might make a new Cowbellaceum in one of the new canvases. The desert one, because you get to use there's Forerunner structures, but also Sanghelios things. So, you know, they have a very, gladiator feel to them. A lot of statues of soldiers and stuff in the Sanghelios design. So I might use that stuff. I got to add the new weapons and everything. So we'll see how it goes. It'd be nice. But with also King of the Hill, I can now add King of the Hill into the game type. Or bomb or something. Assault. I don't know. Like I had in Halo 4. The Halo 4 one. So we'll see. We'll see. That looks pretty good. I think that's it, huh? I think that really is it. Because I wanted to talk about those game updates. And they're there now. Obviously, I haven't done most of the things I keep talking about, which are the reviews for, like, this stupid phone, or, the games or whatever. All this stuff I gotta record. I record all this stuff, alright? And it's just, like, sitting there on my computer, and I just don't want to edit it, and I don't want to talk about it. And then what happens? New things come out in those games. So it's like, I got to re-record a lot of the stuff. And I just be like right now, you know, I'm playing Marvel Future Fight. Okay. It's kind of like Alliance, Marvel Alliance. That came out on the Xbox 360 and PS4, PS3, you know. And but it's on the phone. And recorded the video, they've had a Gwenpool event, and then they had, of course, a Doctor Strange event right now, and then now they got a Odin event. I'm pretty sure it's for the Thor movie. I don't know when the Thor movie's coming out, but, you know, they got all this stuff going on right now. And then the same with, like, the Marvel Puzzle Quest. I gotta do that. I mean, they've added, shield levels and level 5 characters, level 5 star rarity characters and all this shit, you know? I gotta get to it. Gotta get to it. Gotta put these videos up, or who's gonna watch them? Nobody. But that's what I wanna do. I wanna do this stuff. So I got to do this stuff. This is what I want to do. So, just under 30 minutes here. Cut a few of the seconds off in the beginning because I had the audio set up. Oh my God. As I look and see myself now, this speaker is not working. And this speaker is not working because of the plug, which you probably can't see. Because the plug is kind of jacked up, you know? And it's just not working on the right side. And it's like, if I got to turn it just a perfect way, and then if I push, you know, it'll work, but it's not perfect. It's not 100%, and it's pissing me off. Like, between the controller breaking, and then of course the headset's been like this for a while, but it's been working just fine, and all of a sudden now it doesn't work at all. So I'm pretty sure I can just get a new connection down there, but I don't know. I'm gonna have to get it welded. What do you call it? Yeah, welded, right? I gotta weld it. Because I can't just, twist the wires together and they'll work. I gotta weld it. With a little hand torch. Whatever. Damn it, whatever this. Soldering iron. My God. I gotta solder the thing together. Jeez. Okay, that's it for me. Hopefully you enjoy the games for Titanfall. I don't know. I did okay. I didn't do great. I just could not really like get going, you know. I had some things that worked in okay, but most of the game wasn't that fun to play. So it seems slower. That's what it was. It seems slower. And there's videos online right now where you show where people are running through Angel City, like foom, 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 getting the flag and capturing it and stuff like that, which is great. But that's the only map like that. There is no other maps like that at all. They had to bring Angel City back because of how many people did not like the maps they were playing. That's it for me. That's it for this podcast today. I will talk to you next week. Maybe I'll have more to say. Maybe I won't because it's a shorter week. Have a good one. We'll be right back.
ship.